maybe a little sip, you know, and then you have a little sip, and then you have like five little sips, and then you have like a fucking half of the bar. It's very, very, very hard to say no. Because after you drink a glass of beer, you want the other glass of beer, or you want to get a pint. And then at the end of the day, like instead of drinking one lemonade, you drink three beers. It's like a vicious circle, you know. It's like you have that beer, and then the next day you're tired, so you open a little bottle of wine, because it costs not much energy to drink wine. It goes on and on like this, and then you do nothing of your life. I want tomorrow morning to be fresh, to be active, to be energetic. It's such a good feeling to be at your top physical shape every day. I kind of sabotaged my social life in order to drink less. The more accumulation of the streak, the least you're gonna want to break it. I'm not a drinking advisor. I'm not actually qualified to give you drinking advice. You do whatever you want. I just tell you what works for me. It's like this random kind of moment where I didn't really plan to make a video, but I'm like, I really want to capture that kind of that conversation I'm having with myself in my mind. One of the biggest change in my life recently that I kind of want to share on YouTube at some point. One is like why I stopped drinking alcohol pretty much completely while I was drinking pretty regularly in the past. And the other one is why I quit my job 6 months ago now. It's a story that I think there's a lot to learn about burnout, about, you know, handling, creating businesses as well, like following your dreams and this kind of stuff. I'm not gonna address the job one for today because it's a very meaty topic, but the drinking one, I think it was worth talking about it. This thought, train of thought started while I was eating dinner right now. I was like, oh, I have a bottle of cider in my fridge, like it. I completely ignore it. I mean, I know it's there. I'm like, I don't really want to drink anyways. It's like, it's very good. It's very tasty cider. It's cider from Brittany. I love it. But I see it. I'm like, it would go very well with whatever I was eating tonight. I'm like, guess what? I don't really want to drink right now. And more it's been happening. I have super fancy beers in my fridge right now that they've been there for more than a year now. I haven't even drank them. It's crazy, like a year ago I was making YouTube reviews of beers, I was talking about my passion about drinking beer and like getting nice beers, nice flavors, nice profile, different styles of beer and so on, I was sharing it on YouTube and I got plenty of beers back then because I wanted to do so many different reviews. I still have a lot of those beers actually, from more than a year ago, so it's kind of crazy. Obviously I still like beer, but I barely drink anymore. It's like before I was drinking one beer every day and some nights in the week, probably a lot more than that. And recently, I mean since COVID pretty much, or like at the beginning of COVID, I think I drank even more for a while. And after a while of this, I kind of quit completely. It kind of went, that's why I mentioned the quitting my job earlier in this video, is because they kind of both went in pair. When I had a job that was like kind of very comfortable, and like I didn't think much about it, it was just like, oh, I do my 9-to-5, I go back home, I have a beer, I go see my friends, like I do whatever. I didn't think too much of it, just life was cruising. Yeah, I wasn't overthinking really, which was good actually. I kind of enjoyed that, but I was drinking a lot basically. Like every day I come back from my work, I'm brain dead. I'm like, I don't want to do anything creative anymore. I like spent all my energy at work already. I just want to sit down and drink a beer, which I enjoy a lot, so I don't mind, you know. Like put a vinyl on and like have a bottle of wine, it's awesome, I love it, you know. But I'm not really happy with that situation, right? Like with the job being comfortable and me, like I wasn't really fulfilled with what I was doing. I was like, you know, paying the bills, I was happy, I was making a decent amount of money. The company was actually pretty good, like not respectful of like work-life balance and stuff, like nothing to complain. I wasn't even like under a high amount of pressure or like crazy, I don't know. But at some point I decided like, oh, maybe I want to do something else that I'm more passionate about in my life. Like it's very sad seeing those 8 hours a day just gone by and you didn't do something that's like deep to your heart, you know? And more it was happening, the more I was feeling bad about it, the more I was like, what? I see my like whole years of my life, big pains of my life going by like faster and faster and faster. I'm like, dedicating so much time to things that I don't value that much. Doesn't make me feel fulfilled, doesn't make me feel super happy about what I'm doing. It's not like the top priority in my mind, in my values, in my goals, but it's paying the bills, you know. So I do it as spend so much of my time with it. I was going more and more crazy about it, like it was making me depressed, kind of, which made me drink a lot more actually back then. And until a point where I'm like, okay, I need to start something by myself. I need to figure out, like, I start my own business, I start my own software. I'm a software developer, so I start my own software as a service. You know, it's like the common thing for people to do to be independent nowadays, I guess. Just, okay, I want to start my own thing. Hopefully, it's like more aligned with my goals, with my values, with what I like to do. Like, I love music. Maybe I find something going with it, or I like content creation, making videos. Maybe I find something with it. I like brewing beer, actually. I love brewing kombucha as well. Kombucha was a big thing for me. Maybe I can find something like it. So, I have thousands of ideas, right? I'm spending so much time. This is kind of becoming the job video as well, or whatever. This channel is a mess. It's gonna keep being a mess, you know what? So yeah, thousands of ideas, and I'm doing my job 9 to 5. And I'm like drained, brain dead when I come back from work. I'm never working on them, right? Like maybe on the weekend, but on the weekend I like to see my friends. I like to go out climbing on hikes or something. So if I want to produce a video, I'm never having the time. Basically, if I want to produce music. It's very hard to find the time as well, let alone like starting a business, creating a small software as a service from scratch or something. It's like never gonna happen, right? So I was like, okay, I really need to quit my job. I tried to negotiate like 4 day week, which would honestly not make that much of a big difference, with just 1 day extra per week. It would help a little bit, like having, let's say, my Fridays, for example, to produce video, to produce music. I would have liked that, but it didn't really work out because I was stubborn back then about it. My idea was like, oh, if I work 4 days, I have more time to rest on the weekend, which actually I'm not resting, I'm producing content anyways. But because when I'm going back to work on Monday, I'm gonna be like even more energetic, more well rested. I'm gonna be more productive the 4 days that I'm working. And then I was like, okay, I should work 4 days but be paid the same, right? Which it kind of makes sense still to me, but it's very hard to negotiate that. So anyways, because I was stubborn about this, it didn't really happen anyways. And then I just said, okay, I need to quit my job, right? And when I quit my job, I'm like, okay, now I'm starting my content creation, like writing blog posts, making YouTube videos for sure. Music, I didn't really plan to make money from it either. I wasn't sure how to deal with that. Maybe some courses about like slapping the bass, something I could teach actually. I've been thinking about many, many different things. Kombucha brewing, I have so many videos I want to share about starting a kombucha brewing business or something. Didn't go anywhere, right? But so many ideas, and now I'm like, oh, I have so much time after I quit my job to work on all of them. And like, I want to be productive, to like fulfill my own goals, to work on my own project. I couldn't drink anymore, it just happened very naturally. Because, like, if I was, I don't know, if I after work or something, I was drinking just one beer, I'm like, oh, like, was a good day, worked a lot, gonna. You know, crack open a nice beer, go on my balcony, chill there. You know, once I open the beer, and I'm done. Like, I'm never gonna make music later in the day. I'm never gonna edit a video. I'm never gonna shoot a video like this one. If I drank that fucking cider earlier, I wouldn't be shooting this right now, I'm telling you. So that's what I didn't even think about it. It just happened. Like, I know how, like, when I start drinking, I'm not gonna do anything productive after. And if I drink more than one beer, more likely the next day, the next morning, I'm gonna be a bit slower, I'm not gonna be a bit as active mentally, and everything is gonna be harder during the day. I'm not gonna have as much energy as long in the day, like very early in the evening, I'm gonna be kind of brain dead again. And then when I'm brain dead, the only thing I can do is just sit down and have a beer. And it's like a vicious circle, you know. It's like you have that beer, and then the next day you're tired again. Very early, you can't work anymore. You're like, I'm so tired, I don't want to do nothing. So you open a little bottle of wine, because like, it costs not much energy to drink wine, right? And so it goes on and on like this, and then you do nothing of your life, right? Which, honestly, I enjoyed doing that, like this time just chilling around, having a nice bottle of wine, having a nice beer. Can't complain about it. I can't blame other people for doing that, definitely. But it's just when I started to want to do more productive stuff with my life to output more things, to produce more things. And I was like, I didn't think about it, it just happened. I didn't drink that beer, even though I love it, it's in my fridge. I didn't drink that wine, even though, like, right behind this camera, I have my wine shelf with, like, pretty cool bottle of wines in it. I saw them every day, I'm like, don't feel like it right now, because I'm like, I want to do other things, right? And then I want tomorrow morning to be fresh, to be active, to be energetic, to wake up with lots of energy, with a smile, with like the motivation to go shoot a video, to go edit a video, produce music, do whatever, like start a business, code my website, whatever it is. And yeah, very naturally, I stopped drinking beer by myself, and then like I have friends and they're like, oh, let's drink a beer together. And you don't drink one beer with friends, right? You go to the bar, or you go to like someone's place, whatever, have a little dinner, and you have five beers and then a bit of whiskey and so on and so on. I love that, like it's something I enjoy so much, right? But at the end of the day, when I come back home later that night, definitely I'm not gonna record a video, I'm not gonna edit a video I'm working on, I want to ship the next day, right? And the next day I'm gonna wake up in the morning, more likely hangover, at least a little bit. And at that point, like all I want to do of my day is like watch YouTube videos. And like maybe if I have some kind of comfortable job that it's like such in the groove that like I don't think so much when I'm doing it, I'm just executing tasks. It's not like a high level of concentration required or a high level of thinking. So I just do my whatever 9 to 5 job and then I go back home, I drink another beer, you know, because that's the only thing I can do at that point. I watch a movie, I watch something. It's good, like as well. I'm not saying it's bad to do that, right? But it wasn't meeting what I wanted to produce, like the things I want to do with my life, I want to ship, I want to produce. Is this thing recording still? I'm not sure I have this like urge to check the microphone, it's recording. So all the things I want to do kind of conflicted with that lifestyle of drinking most days. So I kind of slowly and slowly started still hanging out with my friends, but like I bring more kombucha. But I realized it's very, very hard to say no to beer when everybody else around is drinking beer or like very nice wine or like bring a nice bottle of scotch or something like this. I'm like, oh, maybe a little sip, you know, and then you have a little sip and then you have like five little sips and then you have like a fucking half of the bottle. And at the end of the day, like it's the same thing. It's very, very, very hard to say no. It's not a new thing I discovered, right? It's like the main strategy for people who don't drink alcohol is you don't drink at all, but you can just have one sip. After you give up, you're done. Like it's very, very, very hard to just stick to that one sip or one small glass and then stop it for the night, right? So it's better to say no to it, but it's very hard in the first place. So that's dilemma for me. So then I just started not going at all. Which gave me even more time that night to work on productive stuff and also made sure I didn't drink and I was feeling good the next day to do more productive stuff. So it's like, it's very hard for me to do that. It was a bit of a dilemma because I'm like, I kind of sabotaged my social life in order to drink less, in order to be more productive with the things I do alone by myself, right? And that's a tough decision to take, right? That's a tough just choice to take. I think maybe I can pull the slider back a little bit. It's like about finding balance as well. It's very hard. Like most of the things, most of the mistakes I made in my life, it's always like this. Like I'm going one direction, I'm like going all the way to one extreme where everything gets fucked up. And then I'm like, okay, I pull back completely the other way around and I go to the opposite extreme until it gets fucked up as well. And then I try to find balance. Like I'm never in the middle, right? It's always like I find balance one side, the other. And like it keeps swinging around. And the idea is to make it swing a bit less and less every time. So you like kind of hang around the middle, but you're never really always straight in the middle, right? But it's about finding balance. So that's what I wanted to share today. I say I quit drinking, which is not exactly true. It's basically the time in my life right now where I've been drinking by far, like by orders of magnitude, the least since I started drinking. Because obviously, like at some point in my life, like I wasn't drinking at all, like I was 7 years old or something. Even after I was legal to drink, like after I was 18 in France, I was actually proudly telling to my friends, no, I'm not drinking, I'm never ever drinking, I never ever drank anything in my life, any alcohol in my life, I'm not gonna start today, I don't want to drink at all. And I was very proud of that for a while. I was like Good commitment. I managed to keep that for maybe a year after I was 18, until I was like, okay, it's still tempting, right? Because you see everybody drinking beer around you, like, this shit looks tasty, kind of, you know? And even like my father, you know, it's like the good example for me in my life, like, teach me so much things and like so much good values for sure, especially about not drinking, right? He always told me since very, very young, like, don't drink, don't drink, don't drink. Drinking is bad, like, it's a poison. You're drinking poison, like, don't do that to yourself. It's unhealthy, it's gonna make you sick. He's right about that. And he wasn't drinking, so actually, he lives to the value that he communicated to me, which is good. But, you know, once in a while, and when I say once in a while, it's like very occasionally, he was drinking a little beer, you know, and he looked like he really enjoyed it. So it made me curious, right? So I'm not gonna say, like, you know, it's bad teaching to me or something. It's like, you know, you can enjoy your little bottle of beer after a good hike once or twice a month, right? And then I see that, I'm like, I kind of want to try it, you know. So I'm legal to drink now, my friends are drinking. Actually, after a hike with my best friend, we go to it was a ski station basically, but in the summer, and like there's a little bars and so on, and we were really actually out of water. And so we go there to refill the water bottles, and we go to a bar to refill the water bottles, and we're like, oh, might as well have a beer while we're there. So we get a pint of Leff on tap, my first beer ever, and it was so good. I was like pretty tipsy after that, but really, really tasty beer, like blonde Leff, very nice Belgian beer. After a big, big hike the whole day, so I was like, you know, so much endorphin, so much excitement from the hike. Obviously, like, you enjoy whatever you're gonna drink, and Leff is pretty good beer anyway. So I was like, okay, that was a good experience, I enjoyed it. Maybe I'm gonna, you know, drink a little bit once in a while, you know. Just I was like, ah, I'm not gonna drink every day, right? But next time I'm with my friends and we're going to a bar, like before, I used to take mint syrup or mint Diabolo, which is like mint syrup and lemonade. And then everybody was drinking beer, and it turns out, and that's also something that played, and that's actually bad. Like, bars would do that, that's bad. Like, the lemonade, like the mint Diabolo, was actually more expensive than a glass of beer. For a while, I was drinking the lemonade, and like, at some point, I was like, it's actually cheaper for me to buy the beer. And now I drink one anyways. I can, you know, once in a while, I can have a little glass of beer as well in the bar. So I drink a glass of beer. But then it's not actually cheaper, because after you drink a glass of beer, you want the other glass of beer, or you want to get a pint. And then at the end of the day, like, instead of drinking one lemonade, you drink three beers, and then you spend more. Even though the beer is cheaper than the fucking lemonade in the first place for some reason. But then after you put the finger, right, like, it's. You know, you go around the wheel, like, do you get the idea? It's like, I'm not making a point anymore of, like, I'm never drinking in my life, because I'm drinking my life at that point, and then it's very easy to say yes to a drink. When you don't, it's not like you're breaking a huge streak, right? That's the thing with building good habits, is you want to build a habit for long enough, usually it's like a month, of doing something or of not doing something. And then, after a month of, like, having that good habit, you're not gonna want to break it, right? Because let's say if you want to quit drinking and you haven't drank alcohol in like 2 months, 3 months, and then you're like, oh, I'm gonna say yes to one beer, just one right now. I guess having that streak before, it creates weight on you. Like, oh yeah, I'm on a 3 month streak, and like tomorrow you're on a 1 day streak, or 0 day streak technically. That's very bad, you know, you don't want that. So the more, what's the name of that? Build up, the more accumulation of the streak that you have, the least you're gonna want to break it, right? As like doing sport every day, for example, doing some kind of training is the same thing. Right now, I'm like, I'm saying that, but I'm not living to what I'm saying right now, because I'm still drinking once in a while. But I'm trying to be more like my father in the past, you know. He was having one bottle of beer after a good hike, like maybe once every 2 weeks, maybe once a month even. That's the goal I want to have for me, you know. It's like, I don't want to drink more beer than that. I don't want to drink more alcohol than that. That's what I'm trying to stick to. Like, once in a while, you make a good dinner with friends, maybe you're gonna share one bottle of wine for the table. That's good, you know. Like, don't, no excess. So excess is bad. The alcohol by itself, I can't say it's bad. Like, having just one glass of something once in a while, it's not gonna do much harm to you. You're gonna enjoy it, and like, to some extent, it can be even good to you. I always believe that like one beer after a hike is like good for recovery, for muscle recovery, because it's like basically liquid bread, right? It's pretty good for you in some way. Just don't drink five of them, just drink one beer. And don't drink like a 12% beer, you know? Drink what I call a sport beer, like a very light beer. 3, 4, maybe 5% beer. That's the sports beer I like after sport. Not very strong. Tasty, lots of cereal, very malty. That's awesome. I like that, you know. Or like, there's a good saying that's like, oh, drink one glass of wine a day and makes keep the doctor away or something. Not sure if that's true. Maybe the one glass of wine a day is a bit too much, but it's like if you drink one glass of wine once in a while, probably not gonna do harm to it. It's like if you start to drink the whole bottle, right? Probably not good. You know, you should probably step back about that. So it's all about moderation, and moderation is the key thing for me. Now I quit drinking. It's like, yeah, I drink maybe one beer a week. And sometimes when I drink that beer, I share it with someone else. So it's like I drink one half a beer a week. It's like, that's fine. That's the way I want to keep things. That's what allows me to be more productive every day. Like when I go exercise and I go climbing, for example, I know I'm gonna be fresh, I'm gonna be active, I'm gonna be energetic, my muscle, my energy level, everything. I'm gonna be at my top physique, right? The best potential every single day. And it's such a good feeling to be at your top physical shape every day, to not be hangover, to not be like a bit tired because you went to bed late because you were drinking out or something. It's such a nice feeling that I got addicted to that feeling good, you know, to that feeling fresh, feeling aware, feeling energetic and motivated about things. I can't say it's every day like this. Like even naturally, without any alcohol, I have days where I'm slow, I'm like in the fog, and I'm not very productive. It happened, that's fine. But I minimize those days a lot since I quit drinking. That's the biggest deal for me. That's why, that's what I do, you know. It's like good for sports, as I was saying, it's good for productivity in general. Like if I'm gonna record a video, if I'm gonna edit that video, which is pretty long actually, it's like a live stream. I mean, a live stream that's not interactive because I'm alone talking to the camera. But I think maybe someone is gonna watch it and is gonna vibe with these values I'm sharing and is gonna want to change something about their life. I don't know. You let me know in the comments if you watched until there. That's pretty impressive actually, and what you think of everything I'm sharing. I hope it's useful. I hope it can help someone maybe get in their best shape, get in their best productivity, ship, you know, the project they care about, deliver like their goals and so on. I hope I can help you do that by making this video. I think that's everything I wanted to share for today, basically. I talk about the drinking, the way it makes me feel good stopping drinking, as the way it happened very naturally when I got to a point in my life where deep inside me, I wanted to be productive, because that was basically my way out of like working a 9-to-5 job that I wasn't really passionate about. So I was like, okay, I have to create something for myself. I have to be productive. I have to like find a way to monetize my passion maybe, or like to start a business. To do this, like I have to, you know, I have to work my ass a bit. Like I have to get something going. I have to get some productivity to deliver some value. And to do this, you can't be drinking all the time and like being low energy and being hangover and like, you know. So it happened without thinking about it. Maybe the tip, if I'm gonna give one tip, get your life to a point where you're naturally, like very deep inside you, you're gonna have that urge to be productive, to like be at your best shape every day, physically and mentally, be at your in the best state possible to achieve the things that you want to achieve. And to that, to be in that state, the things that you want to achieve need to be very important to you. Deep inside you, you need to be really like intrinsically motivated to do it. And when you reach that state, then quitting drinking, quitting alcohol gets much more easy because you notice how much you can achieve when you don't drink tonight, and tomorrow morning how you're gonna feel if you didn't drink tonight either. And it makes you so happy to be in that clear mind state where you can go, you can do the things that you want. It makes you so happy. And you do more, and then you're like, oh, I worked so much today, maybe I deserve a little beer. But then you're like, oh no, actually, because I want to do that tomorrow too. And then you get in that train where it's a, you know, it's a good circle, it's a virtuous circle, and you just basically weeks happen and you're like, oh, I didn't drink a beer in like a week or 2 weeks or a month, and you're like, what the fuck? And that's so good. And I am the guy, I still love beer, I still love wine, like your whiskey, scotch. I've had such good taste and flavors with those, and I still brew beer myself. I drink one of my beer once in a while. But it's like, even though I still love it, I don't feel tempted to have a beer right now. Because I know how good it makes me feel to not drink it. Or if I'm gonna have a beer, maybe it's gonna be once a week, I share it with a friend. And that's good, you know. So that's, I'm so happy I'm sitting in that position right now that I can say that. Finally, I reached a point where I could, you know, go the other way around, where I quit completely, and now I find I'm still mostly on the quit completely side, but like I pulled back a tiny bit where I allow myself a little drink, maybe a beer, one beer a week. That's about it. That's it for today. I hope this I hope you learned something from this video. It motivated you to achieve your goals, to quit drinking maybe, or maybe not. Like I'm not a drinking advisor, right? I'm not actually qualified to give you drinking advice right now, so I can't really tell you to quit drinking. You do whatever you want. I just tell you what works for me. That's the main thing here. And you take away whatever you want, or maybe you don't agree at all with what I said, and like let me know in the comments if you really don't like what I said, if you really think I'm wrong for saying that. I'm really curious to read all of you want to say in the comments about it. Put a thumbs up on this video if you liked it, and subscribe to this channel if you're not already, because I might make other totally random videos like this one, even though it's totally different from what I publish normally. And I'm supposed to make the one about the fact I quit my job 6 months ago, and like what am I doing now? Like, did my business work? Did I find another job? What did I do? You know, I'm not telling you, but I might tell you in a video. So if you subscribe, you're probably gonna see it. And yeah, that's it. This is probably way too long. How many is that? Like, oh, 30 minutes. Oh well, enjoy the 30 minutes video, because I'm not gonna cut it. Peace.